ओमज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामयं तदातिशपदन्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरुर श्रीयुतपदकमलम् श्रीगुरुना वैष्णवं च श्रीरूपं शाग्रजातं चौघनरघुनाथ नितं तं सजीवं साधयितं शवधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् चौघनललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितं च। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाशादि गौड़ भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। मुखं करति वाचलं पंगुलंघायति गिरिं जत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंद माधवं श्रीगुरुदीनताड़िनं श्रीचैतन्यईश्वरं हरिओं तस्सत्। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई जस्ट टू पे माय हम्बल ऑबिसेंसेस टू हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। बाय हिज मर्सी वी आर नाउ टू असेंबल दिस ऑस्पिशियस क्लास। सो थैंक यू ऑल द डिवोटीज टू अटेंड द क्लास। स्पेशली आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम आई कैन गेट ऑल द Nice devotees association. So this is my great honor that you are still to listen to the class. Thank you so much. So take my humble obeisances. Pancha kalpataru bhartso kipashindu bevacha vatitanam pavanebha vishnume bhai namo namo. Ananta koti vishnu bhakta brindu ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Guru Maharaj ki jai. So I request to all the devotees, those who are in Zoom class, please to switch on the camera, then it will be nice. So last, today our, the class topics is that how to uproot the envy, that how to overcome and uprooted the envy. So this is very, very crucial understanding to our spiritual life, because according to the scriptures, we know that our main problem to this material world, we are coming and sufferings. Main problem is that we are envious to Krishna. If you read in the scriptures, that our soul is the part and parcel of Krishna. So it is in, it was in Goloka Vrindavan. Then how is it come to the material world? So it is coming because we are envious to Lord Krishna. Oh, he is the enjoyer. He has a lot of gopis. He is the supreme controller. He is the controlling everything. That's why we are envious. Why I can't? How can I become enjoyer? How can I become controller? Then Bhagavan Krishna saying, then you can do one thing. You go to the material world, and you will become a controller, and you are just to enjoy with the ladies, then you can see that you can manage everything. That's why the root cause of our sufferings, the root cause of our descending from the spiritual world is the envy. So that's why we have to understand the root, the cause, and how can we uproot it, the envy from our heart. That we will discuss today. So here, just to continuation of our Bhagavad Gita, actually, I told you that I am giving the class on the basis of Bhagavad Gita, because all the solution is from, get it from the Bhagavad Gita. So Bhagavad Gita is the knowledge, that which knowledge is sufficient for a life to be go back home, back to Godhead. That's why we are continuation is to going on. So last class we spoke from the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 1st, 23 number sloka, 22 and 23. Sorry, 24 also we discussed. So now today we will discuss from the first chapter, 25 number sloka. So 25 number sloka we'll discuss today. And from there, we'll just to find out the root cause of our enviness and how can we uproot our envy. So please, if you have a Bhagavad Gita, I definitely believe it, you have a Bhagavad Gita. So please to open first chapter, 25 number sloka. First chapter, 25.
Bhishma drona pramukhata sarveshamacha mohikshitam ubacha partha paishyattano samabetano kuruniti. भीष्म द्रोण प्रमुखथ सर्वेषां च महिक्षिताम् उवाच पार्थ पश्यत्तान् समवेतान् कुरुनीति कुरुनीति.
सो आई एम रीडिंग फ्रॉम ट्रांसलेशन फ्रॉम प्रॉपर. Arjuna said, "My dear Krishna, sing my friends." No, sorry, this is 28, sorry, 25. In the presence of Bhishma, Drona, and all other the chief trains of the world, the Lord said, "Just behold, Partho, all the Kurus assembled here in the presence of Bhishma, Drona, and all the chief trains of the world, the Lord said, just behold, Partho, all the Kuru assembled here." So that means the Lord take to the chariot in the middle of the battle and says to the Arjuna, "Arjuna, look, the Bhishma, Drona, and all the other chief trains of the world is to attending there." So my question is that, why Lord Krishna here especially to mention the two names, Bhishma and Drona? Why? He can tell to the other names also. Why he didn't mention the Duryodhana's name, other the soldiers' name, only Bhishma and Drona? Why? Because Krishna knew the weak point of the Arjuna. Arjuna's weak point is for two persons. One is Bhishma Dev and one is Dronacharya. That's why Krishna take to the chariot in the middle of the battlefield. And whose place he took the chariot? He took the chariot. Where is the Dronacharya and the Bhishma Dev just to standing? That is the place he stand up the chariot. So we have to understand our life is like that. The Krishna is to facing our life. Where is our envy can start? We can stop our enviness and just to keep continue. See that how to envy here is coming. My question is that Krishna knew that Arjuna's weak point and the weak person is the Dronacharya and the Bhishma, because Arjuna is very weak for them. Then why Krishna take to the chariot that place? Because Krishna thought that if Arjuna is not to, if Arjuna not to see that who is coming to fight with him, then he not to be envious for the fight. First, you have to understand, if you need to fight, you need in your heart enviness. But two types of enviness. One is shattik enviness, one is the bad enviness. Just like if you want to fight to someone, if you have not some revenge or the you have not some envy mentality to them, then you can't fight. You say, oh, Prabhu, everything is the super soul. How can I fight? They are a Vaishnava. Then you can't fight. That's why Arjuna, Krishna, take to the Arjuna's chariot in front of the Dronacharya and the Bhishma. Krishna wanted to show that, Arjuna, you are weak for them. Look at, they are the envious person for you, that they come to fight you and kill you. Fight you. So our life, Krishna also to set up like this. To whom you are love in this material world, with the blindly, without any, I mean the spiritual reason, for the material purpose, they will be the envious person in your life in future. That's why you have to write it this sentence. If you love, just like if you love a girl, so if that girl, if you are love with the blindly, without any scientific reason or spiritual reason, Krishna in a time being, that girl make you as an envious and a, for your the enemy. So that's why always to understand. Envious, another word name is the animism. I mean the enemy mentality. So that's why Krishna take to the chariot in front of these two persons. Because if Arjuna not to know their mentality, then Arjuna always to be weak. Hana? Sometime if I tell to the Paramatma Prabhu, Prabhu, you are continue these classes, Zoom classes. Do you know that to whom you are invite this class, somebody don't like your these classes. They are very envious. Prabhu, I don't believe it. They can do like this. I said, Prabhu, please be open your mind. Then you can see. Always to remember, write it down this sentence. Two things, if you are not to open, you cannot to get the benefit. What is this? Umbrella and mind are the same. How? If you not to open the umbrella, you cannot to get the facilities from umbrella. If umbrella is closed, you will always to be showered by the rain. Same like, if your mind, if you are make it conservative, you cannot to see the world, how people are cheat you. That's why umbrella and mind is the same quality. Umbrella, if you open, then you can use it, you can get it the benefit. Same way, if your memory, if your knowledge, if your brain, if you are just to open, then you can use it and you can get the benefit. So same like umbrella and the mind is same work. If you not to open, then you can't see how people can just to use it. Understand? That's why Krishna wanted to awaken the mind of the Arjuna. Arjun, to whom you are weak, they are already too envious to you. Otherwise, how they can fight against you? You are thinking this Dronacharya is your guru and Bhishmadev is your great-grandfather. But do you know they are already envious? Otherwise, how they can come and fight? So you can understand. You can understand. That's why write it down this point. If you wanted to uprooted the enviness from your life, from your heart, then you hear how envy manifests and recognizing the fact that we are affected by it. Hearing will awaken us from our unconsciousness, our spiritual coma. The more we are covered by the mode of material nature, the less we are aware of our own shortcomings, that as our heart becomes gradually purified, we will become more perceptive and sensitized to the recognize our subtle anarthas. On a same like a dirty clothes on the string, you cannot to see the dirt. But if you look at the plain cloth or the clean cloth, then immediately you can string can see the dirt. Same way, if your heart by the hearing of this person not to clean up your shortcomings, you cannot to see the reality. You cannot to see the reality. That's why this is the first point. How can you uproot the enviness from your heart? You first to hear. Just like I gave an example. If I didn't say to the Paramatma Prabhu, Prabhu, do you know that you are organizing the Zoom classes? You are inviting so many Matajis, Prabhuji. Do you know that how the background, backside, what they say? Prabhu, I don't know. I know this Mataji is very nice. I know the Prabhuji is nice. I said, Prabhu, they are backside to telling you. You are advertising yourself. You want a name and fame. That's why. Prabhu, I don't believe it. You don't believe it. Okay, I'll show you. Then I show some aspect. Then you say, Prabhu, you are correct. I am very open-hearted, trusted heart, clean heart I have to see. I said, that's why, Prabhu. If you don't know that their shortcomings, if you not to hear, then you don't know that how they are treating you in the backside. So like this, if you wanted to uprooted your enviness from your heart, then you first to hear that what people in background to think about you, then you can overcome your enviness. That to whom, how can I just to overcome these things? So this is the one point. You have to. That means if you want to overcome your enviness, you can more hearing about enviness. How envy is coming. How envy can affect our heart. How envy can affect our life. That's why you have to hear. How envy. Just like if you read in Mahabharata, if you read in Ramayana, that Kaushalya, by the enviness for the property, he just to even the cheat with the husband and to take the whole property dynasty on the behalf of Bharat and the whole Ayodhya make it massive. So when you hear these things, so next time when you are going to dealings with your property, that time you will do with the papers. Yesterday, reciting our Chaitanya Charitamrita class. So there is one chapter we are reading, Sakshi Gopal. So when the younger Brahman, just to confirm that I'll go to Vrindavan and bring to the Gopal to give the evidence that the elder Brahman committed that he will give the marriage to his daughter with me. He said, I can go and bring the Lord, but before you have to give me the writings. Otherwise, I don't bring it. Because now you can cheat. Again, I will come bring to the Lord. Then you can again to make it the new cheating. That's why you first to give me the writings. Then I can assurance to get it. Then I bring the Lord. So like this, if you don't know, if you're not to hear, then you cannot to clear up anything. That's why you need the clearance. That's why I said, a dirty clothes, you cannot to find out the dirty in the strain. Same way, if you in the plain clothes, the clean cloth, if you look at, easily you can see the darts. Easily you can see the dirt. So you don't know that how envy is in your heart. If you not to hear about the envy, otherwise you can think, Vishakha Mata is saying, oh Prabhu, I am free. I have no envy. I have nothing. I have no shortcomings. Anup Prabhu think, Paramatma Prabhu think, Prabhu, my heart is ruined. And I can say, such like I'm giving example. Paramatma Prabhu, do you have envy in your heart? No, Prabhu, I am a pure heart. I am a His Holiness Maharaj's disciple. I am Prabhupada mission. I am a Vaishnava. I am putting tilak nothing. So Prabhu, do you have, if you have no envy, my question is that when you are just to organize the class, so that time, such an example, you are a good person. Why you are only become host? Why you not to give the chance to another person to be hosting? So that means you are envious. Oh, if someone can come to my position, then today or tomorrow, they will say, oh, I just to do it, everything. That's so you are envious. You are thinking that my position can, someone can take it. So like this, if we not to hear about the enviousness classes, and the scriptures, then we cannot to understand where is the envy is hiding. Envy is hiding. Just like if you go to the, like I'm just to giving example, one of the, such like you are taking one of the room, guest house. So if you are not to sweeping in your room, in your life, so a sweeper come and say, sir, can I sweep your room? Yes, please sweep my room. So you are standing outside. Within a 2 minutes, he swept and come out. And so thank you. You gave a 50 rupees tips. But if it is Leela Shwari Ma, hey, where you are swept? Within a 2 minutes can sweep the room. See the under the cot, look at the corner, go to the under the almira, go to the wardrobe, there is the, all the dust. Then that sweeper can understand, oh, this Mataji, maybe she is the, she own hand, she swept her room. That's why she knew that where can dust can stay. But Paramatma Prabhu didn't know. That's why Paramatma Prabhu think, oh, very neat and clean. But those who know that, he knew the dirt not to standing in front of the floor. Dirt always standing in the corner, under the cot, under the wardrobe, under the almira, under the bookshelf. So it is like that. So if you not to hear from the experienced person, if you not to hear from the scriptures, then you not to understand where is the envy is standing in your heart. Standing in your heart. That's why Arjuna, Krishna take to the Arjuna chariot in front of the, in middle of the Dronacharya and Bhishma. Because Arjuna's heart is neat and clean, that Dronacharya and Bhishma is on the my side. They love me. They trust me. They are, very loving to me. But Krishna is the rubbish person to telling me to kill them. That's why Krishna bring them and to show their face. Look, Arjuna, who are they? Who are they? Look at their face. If they are a good person, then why are you coming in the battlefield to against you to fight with you? That's why this is the crucial point. If you uprooted the envy, then first you listen about envy. That's why we can understand the hearing is not only for the spiritual progress. Hearing also to be maintained our daily life, to overcome our unearths from our life. That's why hearing the scriptures is the most important. Most important. Otherwise, you don't understand how people are there. How are people are there? That's why so many times I, Vishakha Mataji, I'm trained up, and with the finger, I look at her eyes, open her eyes and say, look, look this person. You have so many things to telling about person. Look at this person, how they are. If you not to hear, you can't. That's why few minutes before I gave example, our mind and umbrella is the same. If you not open the umbrella, you cannot to get the benefit of umbrella. Same line. If you not open your consciousness, you cannot to open your brain, open your mentality. You cannot to recognize the real things. Who are they? Who are these? People always to understand. People in front of you, so many sweet words can say. But you don't to be melted for these things. Those who are in front of you say the sweet word, you always to understand they are not your right person. Those you are behind, when you are not present and to do on the behalf of you and to praising you, you always to understand he is the best friend in your life. That is the Krishna. You see, in front of the Krishna, we have so many complaints to Krishna to give it. Krishna, you didn't give me in my life good wife, not to give me good parents, not to give me good girlfriend, boyfriend, property, this, that. But still Krishna is providing everything. My food, my shelter, my parents, my honor, my respect, everything is Krishna is giving. So he's the best friend. We are criticizing, but still he's continuing his service. Continuous service. So this is we have to understand. Now come to the more details. That's why Krishna said, just behold. Krishna says to Arjuna, just behold. Look. Look. That's why we have to understand. If we uprooted the enviness from our heart, then we have to look. Here, look means, always turn it. Here, look means not by eyes. Here, look means through the ear, not by eyes, through the ear. That means Krishna said, now not only see the eyes, hear that what the Dronacharya and Bhishmadev is to think about you. You are thinking they are very kind-hearted person to you. Then why they come to the battlefield to fight against you? Get my point. Now come to the purport. As the super soul of all living entities, the Lord Krishna could understand what was going on in the mind of Arjuna. Mind of Arjuna. Because Krishna knew everything. What is going on in the mind of Arjuna? So what Krishna knew? Krishna knew that Arjuna's mind is thinking. Krishna is a cheater and a very unkind person. These persons are very, very kind-hearted to me. This especially my guru, Dronacharya and Bhishma. But Krishna, this is so cruel not to teach me how to respect to the elder person, how to respect to the gurus. So that's why Krishna can read the mind of the person. That's why this is the teachings for us, our life. If you wanted to guiding to someone, first you have the quality to read the mind of that person. You cannot to become a guru or you cannot to become one of the counselor if you have the knowledge to read the mind of the people. If you cannot read the mind of the people, you never become the guidance. You never become the parents. Sometime I tell to the Lila Shuri Mataji for her daughter, you never become a mother. If you not to read the mind of your child, what Jayaradha want to say, what the Hema say, just like mother, when Hema can cry, mother can. I just Hema cry and I said, Hema, take this banana. Then Lila Shurima smiled and said, Prabhu, you are not a mother. Now my child don't want banana. my child now want my breast milk. That's why you are not a mother. That's why I don't understand. So this is the I2 person. To read the mind. Why my child is crying? So same way, Krishna, if you wanted to uproot it to the envy, first you can read out the personality's mentality. What he says, what he want to say. If you not to understand, you cannot to control that person. You cannot become a guru. You cannot become a counselor. You cannot to become a parent. You cannot become a good wife. Why modern days, husband, wife, they become quickly divorced? Because both are buddhu. They are just to physically attached, but they not to read each other mind. But previous life, our village mother, they don't have education, but they can, oh, my husband now coming to outside, now raised mind. Now I don't say any problem of the family. Now my husband come, I just to give the towel, take shower, good prashan, sleep, wake up, then I tell. Modern days, oh, you came, take this. This is your children school bill. This is electric bill. She's so buddhu, not to understand. A person is coming from outside now. His mind is raised. First, he need to eat, rest. Then in the cooling brain, you can pay all the bills. So this is the understanding. That means you have to be the mind reader. Mind reader. That's why you have to understand the point. That's why Krishna is saying, I know that what is mind of Arjuna is going on. Then Prabhupada is saying, the use of the word Rishikesh in the connection indicates that he knew everything. That means Krishna is the Rishikesh. Rishikesh means he is the controller of the, all the senses. So he knew everything. He knew everything. Then Krishna says, the Prabhupada says, the word Partho or the son of Kunti or the Pritha is also similarly significant in the reference to Arjuna. As a friend, he wanted to inform Arjuna that because Arjuna was the son of Pritha, the sister of his own father, Vasudev. So he had to agree to be the chariot of Arjuna. Why? Now go to the, I am reading now the sloka, Vishakha Mataji. I'm reading the sloka, 4th chapter, 26. So here, why Krishna's, Arjuna's name not to mention as Arjuna? Why Krishna call him as a Pritha? Like this. First, you have to understand, how can uprooted the enviness from your heart? This is another point. When you are counseling to someone, first you make the trustness in his heart. Arjuna, why tell, Krishna, why tell Arjuna's name here is a Partho? Why? Arjuna, Krishna tell to his name is Partho for these things to gave the assurance to the heart of Arjuna. Arjuna, you are the son of Pritha. Pritha is my mausi. I mean my father's sister. So you think about it. I am not your envy person. I am not an enemy of your life. I am your relatives. I am, you are blood connected to me. So be trust on me that these personalities not your good for your fortune. So this is the teachings for our life. If we wanted to uproot the envy from our life, or someone like enviousness, if you uproot it, first you make the trustness into the heart of that person. Into the heart of person. Sometimes people are saying, oh, darling, I can get married to. I remember one of the foreign girl in our Vrindavan, one of the brahmachari was so trust to that girl. That girl said, you don't trust me. Let's go to Mathura. We make a court marriage and make a paper. You trust me. I'll go back and come back and make my parents all the problems solved and come back to your life. That girl didn't come. And I said to that boy, in this world, except Krishna. Don't trust anybody. And Krishna and Krishna's devotee. Now you can see what cheating that girl did. What cheating? So that's why Krishna is giving to the assurance. You not to keep the trust to me, but you can keep in the trust to Bhishma Dev and the Dronacharya. Look at this now. Who is the trustable person? I already told you they are the very envious to you, but you don't believe it. But now you look at. Now look at who are they. So that's why Krishna, he had to mention the name of Arjuna is the Partha. Partha. That means through this word, Krishna remind to Arjuna, I am not your enemy. I am not your enemy. You are my maternal brother. Your mother is my mausi, my father's sister. So how can I just to doing some cheating to you? Cheating to you. That's so we have to understand. So uprooted the envy to someone hard. First you, when someone be envious to you, how you can uproot it? First you make yourself trustable to that person. Trustable that person. Then you see, the Krishna is more saying. Now, Prabhupada is saying, now what did Krishna mean when he told Arjuna to behold the cruise? So Prabhupada is asking that behold the cruise. So that means what Krishna wanted to say here. Behold the Krishna, Kurus or Kauravas. Krishna said, look at them. So that, what do you mean? What do you mean here? To Krishna said that, behold the Kauravas. So Prabhupada said, did Arjuna stop there and not fight? That means Krishna wanted to say that you stop and fight with them. Krishna never expected such things from the son of his auntie's son, Pritha. That means Krishna was very regretted that you are the son of Pritha, who is very trustable to me. I never expecting that you become Buddhu like this, that you cannot to trust me. You can trust to the Dronacharya and to the Bhishma. Your mother, father, your whole dynasty to trust me. And you cannot to trust me, you trust to others. Trust to others. In my personal life happened like this. My auntie, I told always, don't hear from some other person. Be trust on me. My auntie one time got in a big problem, in property problem. Her everything has gone. But she couldn't trust on me. Couldn't trust. Now cry to me. Now and say, you are my everything. You are the Krishna. I said, now you Krishna can tell, but what will problem? Your everything has gone. That's why you have to be the mind reader. That who is really in your life is the blessings. Who is the really blessings to mind? Today I went to Lohi Bazaar for some purpose. One devotee is here, something he is shopping. So one Mataji from America, she is a Bengali. I am just to counseling her. So she just to, without my consent, she had some dollar she wanted to, but she has no good relation with the husband. But she's going to purchase one of the flat in America. And I said, oh, Mataji, you are so foolish. You understand your husband is not on the behalf of, favorable to Krishna consciousness, then why you are going to purchase the property in America? He can looted everything from you. Rather, you can purchase the property in India. Something happen, you can come, because here is your all the forefathers is here. Then I giving so many examples, so many. Say, Prabhu, you are just to blooming my mind. Otherwise, I'm already to going to next to it to the pay the carpenting and everything. I will cancel everything. I said, yes. You understand that your husband is not favorable to Krishna consciousness. Something will happen. Today you are okay, you can job. After 10 years, you become more old. You can't do it. If you have some asset in here, then you no need to be the joint venture. You can do it by yourself. So your husband can honor if you have the own asset. But if you are going to the joint venture, if you wanted to come back to India, you can't. That time you are falling in a problem. I know one of the Mataji is in Jobar. She's now crying. She's devoted. Husband is not devoted. She wants to come to India, but she can't because her property is the joint property. That's why you have to be keeping the trust or keeping the wise counselor who is can uproot it, your enviness. Sometimes you are envious. Oh, he's young. Oh, what is this to know? This Sundar Nitin, the young boy. I am so much to know. That's how you understand. Envy, how can kill you if you are bring the enviousness and not to keep in the trust to that person? Always to understand, he is just everything. Just like you sing, Lila Shurima. So whatever to do, just to discuss with me. So it is like that. You don't know the Krishna, how can? That's why the Krishna consciousness person, those who really do in your life, is the blessings. You always to keep in touch that person. You will always to discuss everything. Or if you are envious, oh, I don't respect this and that. If he not to respect, I don't respect. Baba, who is the loser? Prabhu's no need the respect from you. Prabhu has millions of people. You, Lila Shurima, will be loser if you're not keeping contact with me. If you think about it, you have a lot of person. But that lot of person is not Sundar Nityananda. That's why if we uprooted the enviness, we have to understand. That's why in our Bengali one word said, you know what? Je guru dudh dai o guru eta lad dilo bhal. That means which cow is giving to the milk, that cow will sometime to kick you. That is also blessings. Because every day you can get it 1 liter milk. Every day you can 1 liter milk. If your guru is saying, hey, Paramatma, what is you are doing, rascal? You are not to listen. If your guru will one time to say you rascal, that is also blessing. But if your friend will say rascal, that is the enviness. But your guru will say the rascal, that is the blessings, rascal. Because the envious mentality is to cut it, the guru's word. That you are not to discuss with your guru, with your senior personality, you are going to doing something. So that's why to uproot it, then be like this. Now come to the another point. Prabhupada is saying, Krishna neighbor expected such things from the son of his auntie Pritha. The mind of Arjuna was predicted by the Lord in the friendly joking. The mind of Arjuna was thus predicted by the Lord in a friendly joking. So Krishna, by jokingly way, to what is going on the Arjuna's mind is to be rebel here. So such life, if we wanted to uproot it, the enviness is to just lie. That's why if you want to uproot it, the enviness, you need to hear the more and more. So this is the one point. We have a lot of aspects that how to overcome or uproot it, the enviness. But according to the scripture, the most crucial things to uproot the envy from our heart, you have to listen carefully. Listen carefully. That's why Bengali one word said, Bhabiya Shunya Koriho Kas. That means if you're doing something before you think, then you do. After doing, if you are thinking, then you are a foolish. That's why before thinking, you are after that doing. That is the wise man. That is the wise man. That's why if you uprooted the enviness from your heart, then you can listening from the envious pastimes, envious story, envious philosophy, then you can know about how sitting the in your heart the enviness, or some other heart is the enviness. We can easily can recognize who is the envious. Easily we can enviousness. na? We can easily. But if you not to know the scriptures, you don't know. Oh, this is not to speak to me, this, that. But we can understand how. Na? Sabrina Mataji one time, Prabhu, someone of my friend is not to speak to me. I said that person is too very envious to you. That's why don't speak. How you know? I said, you see, if she can speak, she can just to call you, but didn't speak to means that she's envious, that without her, your her concern, you are going to preaching this and that. So you have to understand, because enviousness is so subtle now. We don't know how to sit in your heart. How to sit in. That's why scripture says, na, the six types of anarthas, five things you can divert it in Krishna consciousness. But enviness you cannot to engage in Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness. Envy is like a fence, not to give the chance to entrance the bhakti. That's say envy and fence is like a similar accent. They say envy means no entry. No entry. Envy, no entry. It's a similar accent. Envy, that means no entry. That means if your heart is envy, you have no entry in Golok Vrindavan. 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 Look at these things. One time, one Maharaj class, I heard. Envy's spelling is what? E-N-V-Y. You know? First two letter is to going to the down. N-E-N is to finishing in the down. But B-N-Y, finishing on the top. That means when your heart is coming to envy, that time you wanted to be, that means bombasting, very proud, this, that means you want to be higher. But beginning stage, you are in lower. That's in, that means when you enter in the envy, then your heart immediately going to the rise up. That means you are going to the falling down system. That's what I'm always to say. A wise man says, remember this sentence. No need ribbons. Just wait. Always to understand. The rotten fruits automatically fall down. You no need to ribbons. That's why if someone is to envy to you, you no need to go to the show your enviness. You show your mercy. Rotten fruits automatically fall down as a time being. Because if someone can envy to you, he's get rotting his heart. Or her heart. So automatically after it, 1 or 2 days, or 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 2 years, when the whole fruits will be get rotten, falling from that tree. So a wise man never take the ribbons. A wise man just to leave it everything on the time being. That's a Bengali one has said, in our life, every action, don't take it the reaction. Some reactions, leave it on the hand of the time. Time will show you what is the right and what is the wrong. So that is the wise man is doing. But those who are buddhu, they say, why not to happening like this? I will do that. That's why they're suffering. So be patient. Just wait. Time will show you everything. Every action has an opposite in reaction by the karma's hand. So now you understand how can you uproot it, the envy, more and more listening. Just like today you are hearing the class. Now your mind is blooming, no? So now you can understand how envy is sitting in my heart or some other person's heart, how to sitting in the enviness in the heart. Enviness in the sitting of the heart. That's why hearing is the very, very important process. We can never, ever can think about it like this. We never, ever. We can think, oh, every day hearing the class. Every day reading the Bhagavad. That's how our Subhak Swami Maharaj is saying. The Prabhupada, one word, millions of times repeated. What? I am not this body, I am the soul. Then Subhak Swami Maharaj saying, you are thinking this is like a simple komono. But this sentence, when you can understand, na, you will immediately go to Golok Vrindavan. Because all the sutras is to, all the formula is to hidden in this world. I am not this body, I am the soul. All the envyness will overcome if you understand this sentence. All the animism will go away if you understand one. All the mistrust, all the cheating propensity, all the things will be overcome if you understand. I am not this body, I am the soul. But we are commonly thinking, oh, it is problem, millions of times say. That's why it is a scripture saying, even our Radha Govinda Maharaj saying, scriptures, every word is like milk. But a devotee's life is the bamboo and the churning rope. So scriptures word with the bamboo and the rope, if you are not to churning, you cannot to come out the butter. Butter cannot to come out by automatically. You need to churning. So life is to be churning. Life is not to be by certain or by automatically or by suddenly it can happen. Whatever so-called our scientist is telling, that blasting and just to creating this material. Prabhupada said, nothing is automatically happening. Everything is happening by tapasya. Brahma's tapasya created this world, this and that. So we need to chanting our life. And by chanting, which way? By the good sadhana, good chanting, good hearing, and the good etiquette of Krishna. Like this kind of chanting, you can bring out or come out to the cream of your life, gist of your life. And that butter you can offer it to Krishna. Why Krishna going to the gopis' house to stealing the butter? Because they are hard. 24 hours they are chanting. The sweetest behavior, the sweetest mellow, the sweetest thinking, the sweetest behavior they are cherishing in the heart of gopis. That's why Krishna going to eating that butter. Krishna sleeping on the butter ocean. That Krishna, why going to this poor gopi's house to stealing the butter? That's why you have to understand. That's not a cheap butter. That's a more and more higher than the butter of milk butter. That is the good hearing, the good chanting, good Vaishnava etiquette, the good sadhana. When you do, then Krishna will give you the intelligence how to uproot the enviness in our heart. Thank you so much to everybody to listen this class with your passions and with your concentration. Do you have any questions and comments on these topics? You can tell. Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes,
Prabhu. This is that Mamala Bhishma, August of Prabhupada.
Yes.
Prabhu, there's a verse in the Bhagavad Gita.
First chapter 25.
I envy no, I'm not.
Yes.
The one that, another part in the Bhagavad Gita, it says, I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. But whoever renders devotional service to me, friend,
I'm
a friend to him.
I think so, it is 34 number sloka.
Yes.
That is Krishna said.
Yes, can you explain a little bit about that, Prabhu? What Krishna means by he's a friend?
What Krishna? I don't understand.
No, what Krishna means when he says, I'm a friend to him who's not envious.
That means Krishna said that those heart are envious, na? Their heart is animism. Because yes. When you are, they are not means friend. When you envious to someone, that means you are envious to Krishna. Because why? Every part and particle is the part and parcel of Krishna. So when you are envious to me, such like, you are envious to Sundar Nityananda. So it is not that you are envious to me. You are ultimately to envious to Krishna. You forgot it. This super soul is sitting to Krishna in Sundar Nityananda Prabhu. So why am I envious? If I am envious to Sundar Nityananda Prabhu, that means ultimately I am envious to Krishna. That's why Krishna said, if you are envious to person, that means you are envious to Krishna. That's why, and another meaning is, you understand, you don't envious a person, you envious a person some of the qualities. Just like Paramatma Prabhu, I don't like your talkativeness. So I am not to say that Paramatma Prabhu, I don't like you. I don't like your talkativeness, but not as a man. As your one of the behavior, I don't like. Understand? But our problem is that we not go to the quality, we go to the whole body, the whole life. That's why Krishna said. Even Krishna Bhagavad Gita said that as a human being, we need some enviness. Otherwise, Krishna also told to Arjuna that as a Kshatriya, you need some enviness. Otherwise, you can't fight. Because if Arjuna is thinking, oh, if I am leaving the enviness, then Krishna, how you can tell that, how can I kill them? That's why Krishna said, as a warrior, as a soldier, you need some enviness, but you have to understand where you put the enviness and where you reject the enviness. That you have to understand through the scriptures. Understand? Just like Acharya said, we are hate the Buddhism, but not Buddha. Get my point? Buddhism is a Mayavadi philosophy. Understand? That's why we don't accept their philosophy, but we are respect the Buddha, because Buddha is the incarnation of the Lord. Get my point? So this is like that. So envy we can keep it, but envy not means we are, as a person, we can hate them. Just like Mahaprabhu, he is also too envious to the Mayavadis. He said, don't he listening from Mayavadi. That means Mahaprabhu is too telling like this way, that Mayavadi is not a super soul in the heart. Now they are a separate super soul. Their heart also super soul. Here Mahaprabhu saying their philosophy is bad. But as a human being, you can respect. As a human being, you are respect. Just like sometimes we are saying, oh, this is Gauriya Mata, I don't like it. Oh, this is Ramakrishna mission, I don't like it. Ramakrishna mission, I don't. You don't say like this. You can say, Prabhu, your organization philosophy is not too appropriate with the Gita. That's why your philosophy, I don't. As a human being, I like you. Because you are a human being, I am also a human being. But people are so conservative. People sometimes for that qualities, whole person they are dislike. Or Baba, Ramakrishna people is not a human being. Gauriya Mata people is not a human being. They are also part and parcel of Krishna. We can say that maybe your philosophy, I don't like it. But that not means I don't like as a man or woman. Understand what Krishna wants to say? Bhagavad Gita? Hare Krishna. Anybody, any more question or comments? Sabrina?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Panchang Pranam.
Pranam.
You said that envy cannot be converted into devotion.
No, like envy cannot be converted in devotion.
So, like, what would you call, like, say, for example, like, I'm saying that, you know, oh, Sundar Nityananda Prabhu, like, he's doing 2 lecture. I'm going to try to do like 5 lecture. Or no, you know, he's doing 16 rounds. I will do 20 rounds. Like, they have like devotees like that. It'll be like, oh, he's doing that. I want to do this. Is that envy or?
It is not envy. It is a spiritual competition. Envy is the different things. Envy means you cannot to see his good things, which is make your life is miserable. That means you always to see he is the lower than you. He is the downfall to you. That is the enviness. Understand? But oh, Prabhuji is chanting. Prabhu wake up 3 o'clock, chanting 6 o'clock. I also tomorrow too. Prabhu is going to Golok. This is not envy. This is a good thing. But anything, he better 3 o'clock wake up, na? I will just to do it. Prabhu has a mobile. That's why ring and that wake up. Tomorrow I'll steal the mobile. Then Prabhu can't wake up and go to the Mangalarati. I will go to stand up the Mangalarati. President will say, oh, Sabrina every day come. Sundar Nityananda don't come. He's a brahmachari sleeping. But Sabrina is a grosso but coming. My name fame will come. And this is the emptiness. Lilashuri Mataji's life sometimes happened with her. She's making garland, somebody showing that garland and take the respect. This is the envy. Such a life, Sabrina Mataji make you one of the garland. And I am the group leader. I said, Sabrina, do you have a time? Yes, Prabhu. Would you like to say something? Yes, I am busy. You can do one thing. You make this garland. But don't give it the garland to the temple by your hand. Give it to me. And I take to the garland and say, maybe Anu Prabhu is the president. Prabhu, this is garland. Oh, Prabhu, you are so busy. Still you make the garland. You are such a miracle boy. How can you manage? This is the enviness. I didn't say, Prabhu, actually I didn't do. One Mataji is to helping me. This is, then you are free from it. But when I hide this, that is called the enviness. Get my point?
Yes, I understand. So like in one way to get rid of the envy too would be like to praise others and lift devotees up. And I think in that way we can destroy our envy.
That's why I said, na, when you more hearing, the more good chanting, then your humbleness is coming. Na. Just like when you more hearing, the more chanting, that how can I say, Lilashuri Mataji make the garland. How can I say to Sundar Nityananda Prabhu that I am making the sick? I'm so rubbish woman. No, I have to call. Even if you are just in front of me telling that Prabhu I made, but your heart to listening the Ramayana, listening the Bhagavatam, your heart is poking you. That time you lift up the phone and say, Prabhu, I'm sorry. I told you that I make the garland. Actually, Prabhu, I didn't make. Actually, Lilashuri Mataji helping me. Yes, I just to gave the seva, but all goes to the credit to her. So who thinks is to poking you? That is your hearing. Your heart is telling. I'm hearing from the Shastra. How can I just to telling these lies? Get my point?
Thank you.
That's why listening is very important. Listening is very important. If you don't listen, then your heart will pop. Whatever I'm doing, everything is right. Whatever I'm doing. That's why we are saying that listening, not only your spiritual life progress, your heart is whatever the faults, that also you can find out. If you're listening from the scriptures, from the proper person, then your honor, your shortcomings, you can find out. You can find out. Rakhal Prabhu, would you like to say something? This class is okay or any question? Prabhu is your doctor from Bangladesh. Any questions or comments?
Questions. We have fallen down from material world.
Yeah.
In material world, if we want to develop our devotional life, and it is a most obstacle of devotional life. So it is very difficult to remove. Envy not depend upon the person himself. It also depend upon the surroundings persons. So surroundings have to, if one lives in the families, family members, and those working colleagues also have some enviness. so material, this material source. So we are trying to do it. Thank you, Prabhu.
Yes. That's why, yes, our surroundings can maybe so many obstacles and problem, but if you keep continue listening from the good source, like a proper books, then you automatically can save your life. We don't think about other person enviness. We can clean up our heart. That's why if we are keep continue to always to reading the Prabhupada books, listening from Prabhupada books, then we can save our life. Thank you so much. Anybody more, any question? Anu Prabhu?
No. I just have one clarification. Like, now when we talk about envy, now for example, the gopis, they have two different groups. Like when the example Radharani's group, sometimes they envy Chandravali's group. Is that envy or is it actually
it is not an envy. It is the spiritual love. It is not envy. Oh, okay. Envy, always I say, envy means to be downfalling to you. But which envy not downfalling, rather uplifted to me. That is not an envy. That's a competition. Radha always to think about, oh, Lolita make a good garland and give it to Krishna. Pleasing to Krishna, I will make a more good girl. But when my mentality, oh, Lolita, make it a good girl, I will finish the Lolita. Kill the Lolita. That Lolita no more can make a garland to Krishna. That is the enviness.
Okay.
But when you try, oh, Lolita, make a good girl, I will make a better garland than Lolita. So that's not an enviness. Understand? Hare Krishna. So, okay. Anything more? So, okay. If you have no question, I'll go to the another class, now Bengali class. Then I have a question session also night time. So, thank you so much to all the devotees to attending and to participating this class. Our Pranish Prabhu, Jogesh Prabhu also here. Thank you so much. And also those who are live session. Thank you so much. My Leela Shuri Ma also. So next week, again, we are coming to the another topics. Everybody, pancha kalpa tarubbarcha kipashindu bevacha patitanam pavanibbo vishnume bhainamano anandukari vishnum bhaktabrindu ki jai sula Prabhupada ki jai nitai gaur pramanam. And please to pray for me. I am the envious person in my life. So please to pray for me. I am also can Vaishnava's blessings to free from my heart, always to be the enviness. Because this is the root cause of our suffering in this material world. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Jai Sri Prabhupada.